हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर नरेंद्र काटीकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, बालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रेजेंटेशन एंड डिस्कशन ऑन ब्लो मोल्ड डिज़ाइन पार्ट वन. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिज़ाइन कंसेप्ट फॉर ब्लो मोल्ड डिज़ाइन. स्टूडेंट विल बी एबल टू अप्लाई द डिज़ाइन कंसेप्ट फॉर मोल्ड डिज़ाइन. द कंटेंट फॉर दिस प्रेजेंटेशन कम डिस्कशंस आर इंट्रोडक्शन ब्लो मोल्डिंग डिज़ाइन फीचर फॉर ब्लो मोल्ड डिज़ाइन. लेट अस इनिशियली इंट्रोड्यूस अबाउट द प्लास्टिक मटेरियल एंड इट्स अलाइड एडवांटेजेस. एज वी नो देर आर मेनी एडवांटेजेस प्रॉपर्टीज फॉर द प्लास्टिक मटेरियल ओवर द मेटल एंड अदर नॉन मेटल्स. इट इज़ बींग यूज फॉर पर्टिकुलरली बिल्डिंग अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट एज वेल एज कंसिडरिंग द रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ मटेरियल फॉर द एग्जिस्टिंग प्रोडक्ट. कंसिडरिंग वेरियस काइंड ऑफ पैरामीटर्स लाइक अ ज्योमेट्री, number of quantity being produced, the varieties of plastic material being used for producing the product, there are varieties of plastic part manufacturing processes. One of it is important one, blow molding. With this image you can understood the blow molding process itself. In the mold, the paraffin is inserted with high pressure air or particularly type of gas. It is allowed to blow and it is restricted with the mold wall itself. With this particular image, blow molding process. Initially, the paraffin is inserted in between the gap of two mold half. The mold half are closed. The air or particularly gas with a specific pressure, it is allowed to insert into the mold for a specific period of time. The molds are separated. The product is ready. The blow molding machine look like this. At this stage of this session, are you able to recall, share some of the application or product that can be manufactured with the blow molding process? Might have seen or known earlier anywhere in real time. Just enlist. Thank you. I think you had enlisted the applications which are matching over here. The application of blow molded parts are packaging, automotive, consumer products, drums for chemical industries, billow shaped shields and double walled carrying cases, etc. Plastic material for blow molded parts. These are the some of the plastic polymer materials which can be processed into the blow molding. LDPE, LLDPE, HDPE, EVA, PP. The blow mold in real looking like this. This is one of the blow mold example. Material for blow mold construction. So for particularly mold manufacturing, these are the varieties of material that can be considered. Aluminium alloy, aircraft grade aluminium, beryllium copper alloy, BCU alloy. It is going to be used just because of its excellent thermal conductivity, corrosion resistance and mechanical toughness. Steel is also going to be used for blow molds for PVC or engineering resins. Miscellaneous materials like zinc alloy can be also used. Blow mold cooling. Cooling of blow molded part consists of three separate heat transfer mechanisms. Conduction of heat in the wall up part, conduction of heat in a mold wall, and heat in a cooling fluid. Just see over here, blow mold cooling. Blow mold half with a cooling water channel. You can see over here that particular sectional view for blow mold cooling. Here the water can be get in and water can be get out, and thus the water is going to be cool down the mold itself. If we see further in more elaboration for blow mold cooling, it is important to locate the cooling fluid entrance near to the bottom of the mold and exit at the higher level to eliminate any air trapping. So this is the particularly important things is consider while blow mold cooling system is designed. External cooling method for blow mold can be also considered. You can see the two different kind of channels are being used for flowing the fluid rather the water. One at the left side which is entered from the bottom one and exit at the top end. Second one externally, that means peripherally, it is going to be circulated so that the cooling of mold can be possible. Internal cooling methods for blow mold: venting of blow air to create turbulence inside the part, blowing with a cryogenic liquefied gas to quickly cool the inside of the part, blowing with a fine mist of water or ice. These are the three different methods can be used. Blow molded part design consideration. Design of a blow molded bottle and other shape requires consideration of the following factors. Materials to be blown, that means which polymer we are going to blow in the same. Size and weight of the product and mold. Of course, whatever the mold material you are going to be used, considering that, there will be the weight of the mold. Contours on the part. Whatever the texture or peripheral geometry on the vertical side wall of the product, that is also affecting the same. Surface texture and engraving, the extension of the previous point itself. Sharp corner and straight edges. How many corners are there? That being a sharper one, are considered critically. Blow opening available and locations. How many openings are there for blowing the particularly air or gas? That is also important one. Number as well as their locations. Parting lines. Considering a complicated part, we have to see over there critically that how many parting lines can be possible over there. Let us see few of the terminologies in a blow molded part. Normally, we are considering over here the bottle like a part. You can see the left and right side geometry. Initially, the left one, I am starting from the base. The base is there, then push up just to stabilize the product on the particular platform. The push up is shown. The vertical, whatever the geometry is there, that is the body, then the neck, then the bead, and the neck finish. Whereas right side, base radius, the foot which is strongly supporting the particularly job, then the waist, then the shoulder, the base of the neck. All these terminologies are required in a further case while you are designing the mold. Rather, these terminologies from the part point of view has to be considered while designing the mold. Corner and edge rounding. You can see the corners and shoulders are mentioned with an abbreviation number 1. So wherever the 1 is mentioned at the 3 location, these are the corners as well as the shoulders. The number 2, bottom corners or the radius. The important thing which mentioned over here regarding the corner and edge rounding, wall thinning in a corner areas should be considered as it creates weaker areas in the molding. Volume adjustment in blow molded part. Volume adjustment can also be done by using changeable insert in the mold for side walls. The depth of these inserts may be changed for adjusting the volume. You can see very well with the particularly mold over here. Neck spouts and other openings. Each part must be designed with an opening which may be utilized to blow it also. Mostly this opening is utilized as a neck or spout. The important dimensions of threaded neck finish are shown in the figure. Bead finish and beadless finish. How it look like? That is beadless in the sense undercut option. So these two geometries can seen over here. Closure type and size. The closure, usually a cap or a plug, is fitted to seal the bottle and allow dispensing of the content. Closure size can be marketing tool also. Figure shows how a large diameter closure present a more massive appearance. Base design. To avoid the rocking bottom phenomena in case of flat bottom parts, the typical solution is to provide a domed recess in the base called push-up. On the stretch blown पेट बोटल कंटेनर्स द बेस मस्ट बी स्फेरिकल ड्यू टू इंटरनल प्रेशर. पेटालॉइड टाइप बेस प्रोवाइड्स अ सेल्फ स्टैंडिंग कंटेनर विथ अ सेवरल एग शेप्ड फीट ऑन विच इट बैलेंसेस. स्पेशल कंसिडरेशन फॉर बॉटल डिजाइन. Some of the most important structural and mechanical consideration in bottle include vertical strength, wall thickness uniformity, highlight deflection, push-up strength, label consideration, rigidity, shape, hot fill capacity, and so on. The most important consideration in bottle include if the bottle is subjected to vertical loading, horizontal corrugation, or billows on the part should be avoided. You can see the figure. Double wall construction used in the packaging or casing for objects such as tools and appliances. Double wall geometry provides greater stiffness and impact resistance. The example for the same is shown in the slide. References for this presentation are Modern Plastic Handbook, Fundamental of Plastic Mold Design, NPTEL website, CIPT, Government Institution Study Material. Thank you.